Ah, that was some really good stuff. Welcome, Stefan Benz. What's up, Stefan?
I am great. Thank you so much for having me here today. How are you doing?
Dude, how old are you?
I'm 14 right now.
14?
14 in September. 26th is my birthday. So that means I was born in 2006. And a lot of people, when I meet them, were like, I was doing this in 2006 when you were born.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. But since you're 14, you're so talented. How long have you been playing guitar, writing songs? What's your musical background?
Well, when I was a kid,
You were a kid? What do you mean?
Okay, yeah, I'm still a kid. I know. When I was like 4 or 5, I honestly didn't think I was going to, you know, do music. I would say I really started, when I was 9. And I've been playing the guitar ever since then. Playing the piano. I play the piano and guitar every day now.
Yeah, I thought the video you entered, the direction was very pure, and we've seen some of your other videos. How do you think this performance reflects who you are as an artist today and potentially where you're going?
So I think you're right. I think the description of it being like pure is a good one, because I feel like in today's age, everything's a lot more like manufactured and so what I want to do is to have more of a natural, raw kind of sound, bring back, you know, just the natural, usual guitar. I like piano ballads a lot, but I know, like, I want to go into a really, like, R&B direction, I guess. And I definitely think it represents what I'm trying to do, because I'm trying to do more of a stripped-down thing and just take it back to, like, basics, you know?
Very cool, very cool. Do you think there's any artists out there that's a reflection of that direction you'd like to go?
Yeah, well, I would say like Robin Thicke. I would say like Bruno Mars. Like a lot of older R&B singers like Brian McKnight and those type of people, I would say.
That's cool. That's cool. Connecting on a deeper level. So the audience, when they're watching you, they're going to vote for people they really love. What do you think it is about your performances, or what do you hope the audience notices in you, and that's why they vote for you?
Yeah, I definitely try to evoke, I guess, emotion when it comes to whenever I do my performances. That's the main thing that I think makes me stand out, is the more, like I said, the stripped down thing. And I think that something like that that's stripped down a lot of the times, it's easier to, I guess, reach your emotions, and it's a lot of times has a powerful message, and I think that's what I do best, and I hope the people out there like it, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. But you know, if you're writing these songs, they usually come from a place of heartbreak or trauma. What has been your personal life like to inspire all these songs you're writing?
Well, for me, I I'm from South Africa, if you didn't know. So, and I moved to the U.S. January 2020 with my whole family. We sold everything. My dad sold his business. And it's a completely different culture. And I feel like, to a sense, that's been a big thing, leaving everything behind in South Africa, leaving friends, leaving family, leaving all the things we had there, you know, and starting like a completely new, like starting from scratch. And I think that's been like some of the most like emotional parts of my life so far, at least. I haven't lived like a lot of life, but I think so far it's probably been like the most emotional, like heartfelt thing so far.
Definitely. I think coming from a place of South Africa, you definitely bring a unique perspective to this competition. With social media playing such a big part in a musician's career now, especially this competition, it's all about, you know, making it yourself, self-made. How has social media impacted your musical career?
For me, I started doing my social media platforms pretty much 2018 when I met my manager, Manny. And I've done my Instagram, my YouTube. For me, I've never been crazy about doing social media things, because for me, I love to just do it like in a room and to do live performances. So whenever I've had to do social media things, it's not my favorite thing to do, but I think it's right now doing social media is the, you know, it's the best way. It's such a great platform for any type of thing you want to do online, social media, you know, it's a great way to advance anything you're trying to do. And I think especially for musicians and music, it's definitely breaking and getting bigger on social media platforms and on the internet. So I've had to embrace it, and I feel like I'm getting better at it, so.
Absolutely, and that's what this competition is all about. There's 8 finalists. You are one of them already, so congratulations on that. What are some things you like to do outside of music? What are your hobbies and passions?
Well, I, in South Africa, play cricket, right? So cricket is like, I always say it's like baseball when really it's not really like baseball, but I guess the similarity is you hit a ball and you have to run from one place to another. But the main thing that sets it apart is that cricket, the ball bounces before you hit it. Exactly. And it's like, it's a flat wooden bat. So it's not like round or anything. And when I told Manny for the first time that I played cricket, he thought it was croquet. And he thought I played like the old man croquet sport. Yeah.
No, Manny, that one is played on, they're both played on grass, but one you hit it on the floor through those little rings things.
Yeah.
Okay, well, why don't you tell us right now why you think you have what it takes to win this competition and essentially be self-made?
So, for me, I am young and I have still a lot to learn, right? And I think that I have a lot of charisma and that whatever I put my mind to, you know, I've always been able to go through with it and be able to come out with the best result that I was hoping for and do my best, especially. When I was learning the guitar, learning the piano with my vocal, I'm just trying to constantly learn. And I feel like I learn from other people. I learn from all the surroundings, you know, all my all the situations I'm put into. And I feel like I can adapt really quickly. So I think I have a good chance to win because I'm learning. And I think that by the end, I'll definitely be better than I am right now. And that's the main thing I constantly try to do is to get better.
Absolutely. Finish this sentence. Winning this competition will...
I think winning this competition will change my life. I think another thing I struggle with sometimes is self-confidence. And I think this will help with self-confidence. I think, like I said, learning. I think with the people I'll meet, with the performances that I'll have to do, I think that I'll come out better than before. And I think that's what it's all about. And by the end, I'll be a better musician than I am now.
Absolutely. Are you still in school?
I am still in school.
Right on. So how does your schedule work with school and music and trying to make this happen?
Every afternoon after I have done my school day, I directly come over to Manny's garage, drive from my school. My dad takes me and I'm here till 2 in the morning. I drive back home. I live right down the street, so a lot of times I can walk at least. Every day, like I said, every single day is just writing songs, piano, guitar, getting better at everything. So that's the main goal.
All right. Well, thank you, Stefan. Thanks for joining us. You are on fire. If the fans at home like what they have to hear from you and see, which I'm sure a lot of young guys do, you got a teenager from South Africa here in the top 8 going for the championship of season 1 of Self Made. So, Stefan Benz, thank you again for joining us. And you at home, if you guys like Stefan and want to vote for him, you know what to do. See you soon.